Oh yes, everyone, very warm welcome to the class. Very good evening. I hope that all your preparations are going fine. All right, yeah, Poonam, Anushka, Sanjay, yes, Satija, yeah, Shalvamani. Come on. So let us see a next very important topic today. It is going to be on your conservation. Right, so before understanding into these conservation and all those things, we should first understand the list of very important terms that are very often used. Yes, Sanjay. So very often that are used for dividing up your organisms. Right, fine. So let us very carefully understand this IUCN list. Right, so this is called as your IUCN. What is IUCN? It is your International Union for Conservation of Nature, right? So you want to conserve the nature. So how you are going to conserve? Based on what is your need, then only you can conserve, right? Fine. So they have defined all these number of species, right? You can find that this EX, it is very black in color. What is that EX means? EX means it is defining that it is going to be an extinct species. Yes. So what about your dinosaurs? Yes. What about this woolly mammoth? Right. So they are no more here. Kiwi. Right. Yeah. So they have become extinct. Right. Fine. So that is what is called as the extinct species. No more they are living. They are totally gone. Right. Okay. So the next category. Yes, everyone. Very good evening. Come on. Very happy. Yeah, Vijay Durga. Right. So the next category is called as extinct, but in the wild. That means in nature they are extinct. Maybe, very few samples you have, in your natural park or your reservoir. You just preserve them only, by the artificial method. But naturally, they are no more. That is what is called as your extinct in the wild. Right. Next important category, it is called as the threatened category. Right. So, what do you mean by threatened? Right. So, threatened, it is going to include the vulnerable species, endangered species and critically endangered species. So, amongst the three, yes, element. So amongst these three, who is having the higher risk? Who is more prone to extinction? Yes, that is going to be your, oh yes, yeah, Chanda, definitely I will help you to understand. So that is going to be your critically endangered species. Yes, so Chandini has a question. I'll just address the question. All right, so I could not access the Unacademy app. So please suggest. Right. Yes, yes. Yeah, anywhere in the world you can access. See, you have the web, right? So, in your Chrome, you can access through your portal, right? So, I do have students abroad also from Dubai they are using, and one was from Belgium. Yes, so definitely, you can access it, in your Chrome, your normal web application. You can create a login and definitely you can reach. Yeah, so only thing, the mail ID, whichever you have given, right, just check out. Also, the phone number that you have given up, just check out. Definitely, you will be able to, log in from there as well. No issues in it. All right. Yes, Chandini, I think your doubt is done. All right. So, coming back to this question. Yes. So, who is prone to more extinction? Yes. Absolutely. So you can use it from your critically endangered one. That is going to be very much towards the extinction. Right. Oh yes. And also with your endangered one. So that comes second. The third one, the little bit one, it is the vulnerable. Okay. But vulnerable, it is also coming under the threatened category. Got it? So, who is coming under the threatened category? So, these are all facing the threat. Yeah, who are facing the threat? Very bad, it is going to be your critically endangered, followed by your normally endangered species, and finally this vulnerable species. Right? Okay, so these three, it is going to be, the threatened one. Right. Fine. So, the next category, it is at the lower risk. Okay, fine. So who are all at the lower risk? It is going to be your near threatened, least concerned, right? And then absolutely. So your data is deficient and not evaluated. So these are all coming under your lower risk category. Mainly it is going to include your least concern LC, that is your least concern, and then NT, it is going to be the near the threatened. Okay, NC, it is going to be the near threatened, least concern, and sometimes you have not evaluated the data, so data is deficient, so you do not know how they are going to begin with. All right, so these are all coming under the low risk category. Fine. So based upon these risks, you should be very careful with the organisms such that you can conserve them, right? So two terms are very commonly used. One, it is called as your endangered species. The other one is called as the endemic. What do you mean by endangered? We have seen that these endangered species, they are about to extinct, isn't it? So they are in the verge of the extinction. Absolutely. So thousands of species of your plants and animals, they are endangered, and every year it is increasing. What is the reason behind this? This endangered thing is not living off. Why? Because of your habitat destruction. Okay, so this is the major way. Yeah, Chandani, you can access from the Chrome. Web version is there. Okay, so you can log in using the web version. Yeah, Chandani, don't worry, you can access through the web. You can use your Google Chrome. You can use your Mozilla Firefox. You can use your, so all those things you can definitely do it. Yeah, so coming to the endangered species, you can, and it may happen because of this habitat destruction. Yes, all the human activity, and they are hunting, right? This is also there. Fine. So all these things will lead to this endangered. And what do you mean by this endemic species? Right. This endemic species, it is found only in a particular region. They are endemic. Okay. So it is present only there. Why it is present only there? Maybe because of the climatic condition. Maybe because of the nutrients. Yes. They are called as the endemic species. All right, fine. And in our India, more questions are coming, isn't it? Yeah, Poonam. So, So, calamities, they may also lead to your destruction. Absolutely. And if you take India, yes. So, we have a special act that is called as WPA. It is called as your Wildlife Protection Act. So, that's why you cannot simply enter into a forest. Yes, you have to get the permission from the collector or this tahsildar or someone, such that you can go inside the forest. You cannot simply go inside, right? You cannot make a trespass, right? So, the endangered species, they are categorized in India as your vulnerable. Yeah. Yes, Vijay Durga. So you are, absolutely. So your kangaroo, they are present only in Australia, right? So they are endemic to that region. Likewise, in India also, we do have a lot of endemic species. We'll be seeing that, don't worry. Right. So these are all the main causes for your endangerment, your destruction of habitat, wildlife trade, yes, as well as over hunting. So these are all becoming, a very, very important thing for your things. Right. And what is this? The snow leopard. See, the snow leopard, it is endemic to Himalayas. Right. So the snow leopards are found only in Himalayas. This wild Indian dog, gone only. Right. So they are endemic. That means that they live only in that area. Your tigers and then your golden langur. Black bucks, right, and then Asiatic lion, they are able to survive only in India. So if at all this habitat is destroyed, then they cannot burrow anywhere, isn't it? So that is why they are called as your endemic species. They are very, very, you know, specific to particular region. So if that particular region is gone, then they will become critically endangered, isn't it? Right. So that is why these very easily they turn into your critically endangered species. Yes. So what is the endemic species? Always these endemic species, they have the borderline to become your critically endangered species. Why? They can be present only in that area. If that area is affected, then where will all they go? They will become endangered only. Got the point? So shall we see the examples of the endemic species? Yes, Anishka, absolutely, they are your specialist species. Tigers, and then your wild Indian dogs, snow leopards, golden langur, black buck, Asiatic lion, Indian peacock, lion tailed macaw, brown fish owl, Indian cobra, your clouded leopard, and Indian elephant, right? Yeah, so they are, you know, on the verge of, you know, your critically endangered one. Indian vulture and cute little red panda. Yes, and then ridley turtles, right? So apart from that, even with the plants, these things are there, right? So they are in the movement towards your critically endangered. Apart from that, already IUCN has announced these critically endangered species. Amur leopard, yes, and then the turtles, and then your Sumatran tiger, right, yes, Selvamani, the animal, it is endemic. Endemic means they live only in that area. In other area, it cannot meet survival, right? So why it cannot survive? The condition is present only there. That is why it is called as endemic. Yeah, Sumatran orangutan, and then swallow. So all these are critically endangered species, right? Should we study all these names? Should we study all these names? A big yes. Why? You get 4 marks. Literally, to study the names, you are going to get 4 marks. Right? So don't forget to study these species. Right? Absolutely. They are coming under the rare species also. So the blue whale. Yes. And then, Bengal tiger. Yes. Ganges river dolphin. Yeah, so all these are coming under your endangered species. All right. Likewise, the vulnerable species. What do you mean by vulnerable species? Thank you, Silamani. Vulnerable species, what do they do? Vulnerable species, they are, remember the order. Oh, Anuja, refresh. So if it is going to be this vulnerable species, after vulnerable, then only endangered, then critically endangered, and then only extinct is coming. Okay, so this is relatively, yes, at risk. That's it. Okay, so it is not still moving into this greater line. Yeah, dugong. Yes, this were earlier conducting. No, this is earlier, it was showing that it is your mermaid. All right, fine. And then the great Indian white shark. Right, and then this red panda, polar bear, right? So this whale shark. All right, so all these are called as your vulnerable species, right? So apart from the list that we have seen here, I have just listed out, this is the updated 2019 list from your IUCN. Okay, so you can just have a look at it. So it is showing that, so this Himalayan brown bear. Yeah, our normal country bear, Himalayan brown bear. Yes, and then this pygmy hog. Pygmy hog, very beautiful. Right, and then your white-tailed screw. Yes, and then this Malabar civet. What a powerful eyes, right? Yeah, so they are all under critically endangered. So they are going to become extinct soon. We are not going to see them back. Right. Endangered animals, especially mammals. So this is from India list. Okay, so always India list is very important. All right, here it is going to include your wild dog. See, this is how your normal wild dog will look like. Yes, so the dogs that we see now are totally different from this fellow. Am I right? Yes, this is this Asiatic wild dog. You call them dole. Yeah, Yes, yes. So, no, these are all your endangered. This is critically endangered, that is almost gone. This is going very fastly. Yeah. So, that is your endangered mammals. Yes. So, that is going to include your Asiatic wild dog. Yeah. Fine. Okay. Right. Fine. The next one, it is going to be this elk deer. Okay. Right. And then this is going to be this golden langur. Fine. So these are all coming under your endangered mammals. All right. Fine. Okay. Fine. Yes, everyone. So this is all clear. All right. Fine. So now let us see how to do. Oh yeah, Chandini. Just a minute, guys. So the website says it is not available here. Oh, is it? Oh, Chandini, I don't have any idea. Maybe you can write to our Unacademy help. Okay. Yes, you can write to this Unacademy help. I think they will definitely get in touch with you. All right. Fine. Yes, Vijay Durga. Come on. So next. So all these things, why we are studying? We want to conserve our nature. That is why we are studying all these stuff. Isn't it? Right. So what do you mean by biodiversity? It is going to be the variety of life. Right. Yes. So the next one, it is going to be the conservation. So what do you mean by conservation? Conservation means it is preserving or it is going to guarding them. Right. So that is what it is called as conservation. Mainly, the conservation is divided into two major types. What are they? Number one, it is going to be the in situ conservation. Number two, it is going to be the ex situ conservation. What is in situ? In situ means within the same area, isn't it? So that is called as your on-site conservation. Can you state some examples? So you are taking some sanctuaries, right? And then your national park. Right? So you are conserving them wherever they are living. That is what is called as your in situ conservation. Okay? So your endangered plant or animal, it is preserved within the natural habitat. Right? Yeah. So you are protecting them. You are not allowing. Yes. So you are not allowing, not laboratory. It is going to be the site only. For example, a sanctuary. Yes. So that is what is, you have Bandipur sanctuary. You have your Mudumalai sanctuary. Right. So I know there are many sanctuaries across India. I am just telling very few examples. All right. So these are all going to be preserved. Right. Anything. Yes. Even for the endemic species also. That is how they preserve the tiger. Right. So it is called as your project tiger. Wherever they are living, yeah, they are going to protect them. Right. So that is what is called as your in situ conservation. All right. Fine. The next one, it is the ex situ conservation. This is what you do in the lab. It is called as your off-site conservation. Off-site means you are taking them, you are removing them from the population, yes, and then you are putting them in the new location, right? For example, you have the zoo, right? So you have your lab, so where you are going to protect them. So you are removing them from the nature and then you are growing them in your own area. So that is what is called as your ex situ conservation, all right? So if you take your in situ conservation, yeah, yes, Anshu. So all your botanical gardens, all your natural park, sanctuary, reserve forest, your biosphere reserve, yes, seed bank is ex situ. You are taking the seed and preserving them outside, right? Yeah, all the bird sanctuary, tiger project, crocodile project, yeah, zoo garden, right? And all these, they are coming into the in situ conservation. Clear? Yes, your Kaziranga National Park is there, Himalayan cheetahs are there, Project Tiger is there, right? So all these are in situ. Wherever they are, you are preserving them. That is called as your in situ conservation. And what is this ex situ conservation? Yes, all the bank, gene bank, sperm bank, ova bank, seed bank, right? So you do externally. So that becomes your ex situ conservation, right? So now clear? the difference between your in situ and ex situ. In situ means it is within the region. So all the natural park, reserve, sanctuary, right? So all these are coming under your in situ park or in situ conservation. Ex situ is all the bank, right? So from the bank only you are doing it. Seed bank, gene bank, huh? So absolutely. Oh yes, Vijay Durga, thanks a lot. So that is the major thing. Apart from that, you create an awareness program, you make a critical, legal action against those who hunt, right? So these are all the other modes that help to conserve our nature. Yes, so one of the most important institute that is helping in achieving this thing, it is your IUCN. This IUCN, oh Poonam, thanks a lot. This IUCN, it is called as your International Union for Conservation of Nature. Okay, IUCN. Earlier it was your Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources. Both, not only the nature but its resources also. All right, its headquarters is situated in Switzerland, right? So they are only releasing this red data book. Okay, so green data book it is there and the red data book it is there. Green data, it is for all those species that have good numbers, right? Yeah, oh definitely. Oh yeah Chandani, I will do it, don't worry. Yes, so that is called as your green data. And what do you mean by red data? Yeah, yes, yes, yeah, yeah. Zoo is not under ex situ. See, your zoo will not come under ex situ. See, your zoo is coming under your in situ conservation. Okay, so zoo, it is wherever you are keeping them, right? But if you are taking them and you are putting it outside your environment. Okay, that kind of zoo is different. So that becomes like, you want to preserve them. You got the difference? Yes. So if it is going to be a zoological park, okay, so wherever they are existing in the same area, right, so you are making up a zoo. That becomes your in situ conservation, right? But you want to preserve them, so you take a sample and you put it somewhere else. You displace them. Right? Whenever you displace them, that becomes your ex situ conservation. Yes? Yeah, Anuja. Good question. Right. All right. Good, everyone. Come on. Right. So that is going to be your IUCN. They only analyze all the data and they give you the result. Yeah, yeah. So the next important one, it is a very important project. It is called as your Project Tiger. Huh? Right. So what is this Project Tiger? You want to serve and conserve the tiger, right? So I told you that tiger is already coming under your endangered species, right? So the tiger, that too it is endemic to India, isn't it? Right. So these are the areas that has been covered. This includes this Shivalik, yes? So this is in your Bengal, right? So that is why we call them as Bengal tigers. And then it is including your Northeast Conservation Unit and then our Sundarbans. Right? Oh yes everyone, that's great. And then your Central India Conservation Unit, Eastern Ghat, Western Ghat, all together, right? This project is covering them. That is called as your Project Tiger. So what is the objective of this Project Tiger? This Project Tiger, it will identify the factors. Why a tiger is dying? Maybe it is not getting enough food. Why no food, no herbivore, no carnivore? Okay, so what is going to do with that? So they were able to do a certain kind of management, right? And then the damages that are done to the habitat, they were rectified. Because of that, they were able to increase the number of tigers. This project started in 1973. Okay, so they were able to maintain this viable tiger population in the natural environment. So this becomes your in situ conservation. Got it? Yeah, so this is all in the natural environment. Right. Okay, so now question time. We will try to fill it. Yes? Fine. So it is going to be, yes, covered. That's great. Come on. So, right. So the Bengal florican, it is a bird actually. Okay, this Bengal florican, right? And then Ganga River dolphin, this we have seen already. Yes, river dolphin, Ganga River dolphin. And then rhinoceros, this also we saw. Indian vulture, right? Can we match it up? Come on, come on. So this Bengal florican alone we didn't see in our lecture today, right? But I will tell you that is coming under your critically endangered species, okay? So that is almost gone, right? Okay, absolutely. Yes, Poonam, you are correct. Your Ganga River dolphin, so that is coming under your endangered species. We have seen that today. Yes, yes, Kavut, yeah, Kamal, come on. So what about your Indian rhinoceros? Indian rhinoceros is vulnerable species, right? What about your Indian vulture? Yes, Indian vulture, it is going to be critically endangered. I think we saw that today as well. Yes, Sanjay Kumar. Oh yes, yeah, Chandini, I do have it. It's Biopedia, right? Okay, very recently I started it, right? So this is going to be the correct answer, right? B. Very good, fine. And this is a very important one. I didn't have the time to put this today, so I have put this question. We'll try to match it up, okay? Right. So this is the list of your environmental agreements that are being made. Okay, high time chance that no, it may come again, right? So you may remember this Kyoto Protocol. That is a very common kind of thing, right? So that is called as Kyoto Protocol. Do you remember the Kyoto Protocol? It is for your greenhouse gas emission, right? Yeah, but that option is present everywhere, so we will have a look at the next one, right? So this Basel Convention, this Basel Convention, it is for transboundary movement of your waste and disposal. Okay, this one you try to remember. So this Basel Convention, it is for restricting the movement of your hazardous waste and disposal, right? This Cartagena Protocol, so what this Cartagena Protocol is meant for? Yes, Elvamani. So that is meant for this biosafety. Even now this corona, this thing is there, right? So we have to dispose the mask, the gloves, yeah? Oh yes, Vijay Durga, definitely it is Biopedia. Alright, so you put my name as well and search, then you will be able to get it, right? So yeah, definitely. So this is a very newly started channel, just I think past 2 weeks, I'm doing 3 weeks, right? Okay, so coming back here, Stockholm Convention. So what do you mean by this Stockholm Convention? So they are meant for your, oh yes, everyone, oh Prabhakar, oh right, oh thanks a lot Prabhakar, yes, good. So this Stockholm Convention, it is going to be the persistent organic pollutants, okay? So at least these few conventions you try to remember, because no, they may come back anytime. Alright, fine, right. So according to the 2014 IUCN list, so which of them it is covering a large percentage of the threatened species, right? Okay, so which is having the large threatened species, right? Yeah, threatened species, threatened, it is going to be an indicator also. Now you will get it. It is an indicator species also. Oh, thanks a lot, Poonam. Yeah, Samyadeep, Jyotsna, Chanda. Yes, it is none other than your amphibians. Yeah, amphibians, they are very much prone to, threatening. Okay, yeah, they are very, their skin is very sensitive also. Yes. Yeah, Selvamani, Poonam, Vijay Durga. Good. The next one, right. So, the species, it has the following characteristics. There is a reduction in population size, okay? So greater than 90% over the last 10 years. Their geographical range or their extension or extent of occurrence is less than 100 kilometers, okay? And area of occupancy is less than 10 kilometers. The population size is less than 50 matured individuals. The probability of extinction is 50%, not bad, right? 50%, right? And in the next 10 years or the 3 generation, so which it is going to come under, right? See, there is a reduction in the population size, right? But if you see the number, the probability of extinction in wild is less than 50%. Okay? So you can eliminate one by one option. Mixed options are coming. We'll eliminate one by one. See, the probability of extinction in the wild is less than 50%. So definitely it is not D. Okay? Right. And what about A? A means it is too much going to extinct, isn't it? It is saying that there is a reduction, but still you can see that they are greater than 50 matured individuals. In a population size, they have in one group only, they have 50 individuals. So at least it is not critically endangered. Okay, so then you will have a doubt between endangered and vulnerable. Yes, now you see, there is a reduction in the population size that is equal to 90% in the last 10 years. Okay, and you see the extent of occurrence. They occur for every 100 kilometer. Yes, so they occur every 100 kilometers. If they occur every 100 kilometer and the area of occupancy is less than 10 kilometer, so do you think that they are endangered? No, for every 100 kilometer they are there, isn't it? So they are only vulnerable species. Got it? Yeah, Jyotsna. Yes, everyone. So I think that this is all clear to you. All right, that's great. Fine. So this is our So the July batch is going to commence very shortly, right? So this is aiming for your December 2020. And this is my plan. Oh yes, absolutely. So this is my plan for your next 1 year, right? So definitely our courses will help you a lot. And I'm going to deal with 9 major units. Yes, so I'm dealing with biochem, cell biology, mol biology, developmental biology, right? And then I'm taking ecology, evolution, methods, applied, right? And then animal physiology. So these 9 units I'm covering up. Apart from me, there are 20 plus educators who will help you to learn through all the units. So these are all the testimony that is given by my previous year batch students, right? So definitely even I wish that you get clear your examination. So you can definitely think of subscribing our Unacademy Plus subscription. The fees range is going to be very reasonable for 1 year with all your 13 units, and then with part A inclusive of all your test series, it is only 11,500. Apart from that, you can use my code Saranya Live. You will get 10% off on the total fees. So don't miss out this wonderful opportunity. Make use of that and get benefited. All right. Thanks a lot, everyone. So join me. And tonight at 8 p.m. in our Unacademy, I have a special class. So that is also for free. So today I'm doing it with your very basic concept, habitat and NIC. Okay, so all the character displacement. Yes, yes. Oh yeah, Sanjay, I totally forgot. Right. Okay, Sanjay, don't worry. Definitely, I will make one more session on your make and break. Yes. So yeah, Sanjay, definitely. I have one more session in make and break. Yeah. So definitely. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, Chandani, I will help you out. Don't worry. Yes, yes. So this is the total thing, right? So time is, oh, Ivanti, thanks a lot. So time is seriously running. Everybody is preparing. So don't miss out your chance. Seriously. Start studying by today. Then it will be very easy for you. And this is my ID. So you, for queries, you can reach me out. Right? Yes, Sanjay, I will take up your query. Right. Oh, thanks a lot, everyone. That's great to have you all on board. All the very best. Keep learning. Yes. Bye-bye. Take care. Till then. See you at 8 p.m.